Hi guys. This time, it is a modification of CNC1310. This was an excellent modification. I am very happy with it. If you have a desktop CNC router or 3D printer like this one, this is definitely a modification you should do. I was surprised to see it in use, which I will explain in the latter part of the video. When you try to machine steel with a home CNC router like this, you usually can't cut it properly. However, this lovely red machine can be machined stably with the modifications I have done before and the modifications I have done this time. The previous modifications were to improve the rigidity and increase the torque of the spindle so that the machine can withstand steel machining. If you are interested, please watch this video. This time, what I did was a modification that can greatly improve machining errors. If you have a CNC router or a 3D printer, you have probably experienced machining or printing errors. The reason why this happens is because of the way stepper motors are driven. Stepper motors have the advantage of easy control of rotation, but they also have the weakness of stepping out of step. For example, if a high load is applied temporarily and the motor stops rotating, the angle of rotation will be lost. Once this happens, all subsequent machining will be offset. Industrial machine tools use servo motors to solve this problem. With servo motors, the encoder constantly checks the rotation angle and compensates, so it never goes out of step. However, few home use machines use servo motors due to cost. So here it is. This is an encoder. The encoder is attached to the stepper motor to compensate for step out. Simply put, an ordinary stepper motor becomes like a servo motor for industrial use. This overcomes the problem of step out and greatly reduces machining errors. For those of you who may not understand what I mean, let me explain it a little more clearly. For example, there are three drunks drinking at a bar. The first guy is called Mr. Stepping. He is drinking at the bar and is drunk. Mr. Stepping is getting tired of this bar and decides to go to the second bar. Someone tells him where the next bar is. He was drunk but managed to remember where it was and went step by step. He could reach his destination exactly as long as nothing accidental happened along the way. However, if he met a pretty girl on the way, he would stop. Or if a car crashes into him, he loses his bearings. In the end, he cannot reach the next bar. This is just a stepper motor. Next is Mr. Stepping's friend. He also decided to go to the second bar as well. He, like Mr. Stepping, basically lost his location when an accident occurred on the way. However, there was one difference from Mr. Stepping. That is that he had a smartphone. So Google Maps was available. Even if he met a pretty girl, or crashed into a car, he could still use Google Maps to find his location. As a result, he can reach his destination. This is the closed loop stepper motor. The last one is Angel. She is an angel of alcohol. She also decided to go to the second bar. She is not like Mr. Stepping. She has the newest iPhone and can use Google Maps. On top of that, she has beautiful wings that allow her to fly. She can move at high speed and always know where she is. If an accident occurs, she never loses her location. As a result, she arrives at the second bar in the most efficient way. This is a servo motor. Was it easy to understand? Looks like they had a good time. This modification is to give Mr. Stepping a smartphone so that he can reach the second bar. If you find this channel interesting, subscribe to it. Let's install it. With this type of Pololu driver, it was very easy to install. Thank you. Encoder installation on the X-axis is complete. It was a very easy task. However, when I tested the operation, the motor did not rotate properly. I always face problems when I do something. I am not very good with electrics, so I thought I would have to look things up again, but it was surprisingly easy. The instructions were right in the manual. It seems that some wiring needs to be changed depending on the stepper motor. I followed the instructions and checked the wiring with a tester. Just swapping the two wires solved the problem. Wiring modifications have been completed. Calibration has been completed correctly. Setup and operation was checked according to the instructions in the manual. When I applied external force, the stepper motor tries to maintain the current angle. Even if I force it to rotate, it returns to the original angle when I release my hand. The error angle is displayed on a small screen, which is cool. I am very satisfied. In fact, I was surprised when I tried to run the motor with this encoder. It is the motor sound peculiar to stepper motors. Many people find that sound noisy. However, by using a closed loop, it became almost silent. I thought to myself what this means. Probably because it reduces the impact noise at each step. Because, the manual says that the current is automatically controlled. In other words, I think the amount of current is minimal when there is no load applied. Sorry if I am wrong. Anyway, listen to the sound difference between the YZ axis and the X axis with the encoder attached. How is it? The X-axis motor is almost silent. In actual machining, the machining noise is louder and the motor noise is not a concern. But if you put this on a 3D printer, you can use the printer without caring about the noise. Back to the story. Install the encoder on the Z-axis in the same way. These are the parameters I have set for this machine. Please check the details of the parameters in the manual. I don't think it is that difficult, but if you're planning to use the same machine, please refer to this. The Z-axis is also complete with encoder installation. The last one is the Z-axis. The Z-axis has a handle on top of the stepping motor, so it is not possible to install an encoder as usual. A little ingenuity is required. The encoder could be installed on the Z-axis. All axes can now be moved in a closed loop, which should greatly reduce machining errors. However, there is one more thing to do. The electronic board is exposed. This will cause a short circuit when the steel is machined because of the chips. Not very cool, but I will use this. Completed. As a test cut, this sheet metal will be machined to make a stepper motor bracket. This part is for a 5-axis CNC machine that I am currently making. If you are interested in CNC routers, this 5-axis CNC machine project is also very interesting. Because it is a very insane and original design. Now let's try machining. The CAM software I used is Fusion 360. Until now, I had been careful not to set the machining conditions too high, because I was worried about step out. However, with this modification, I don't have to worry so much anymore. I am very satisfied. I haven't decided what modifications I will make to this machine next, but there are many things I would like to do. Please look forward to the next modification. See you soon.